is your roving reporter, a Snooty Sue. Snoopy Sue at Unity of Fort Myers. Today we are talking to members of Unity and getting their opinion on the Capitol campaign. Getting their feelings on the Unity Grand Adventure. As you know, members of Unity are well known for their strong opinions and famous for their willingness to share them. This could be one of our more exciting days. Oh, here comes a church member now. Chicky Klutz, who owns the chicken farm just outside of town. Miss Klutz, I'm your roving reporter, Snoopy Sue.
I know who you are. What do you want?
Well, you've been a member of Unity for a long time. What do you think of the plans for the new building program? Do you think it's really necessary?
Well, I don't know if it's any of your business. Where do you get your preaching anyway? Not here, that's for sure. Never mind. I'll be glad to tell you. I have raised chickens all my life. I have a farm just outside of town. And I'll tell you the most fundamental thing about raising chickens.
Miss Klutz, I'm asking about the new building program and whether or not it's really needed. I'm not asking about chickens.
Well, I was getting to that. If you'd stop interrupting me. As I was saying, the most important thing about raising chickens is chickens die to the size of the coop.
That's my opinion.
What do you mean?
You mean you don't get it? Chickens die to the size of the coop. If you want to raise more chickens, you need a bigger building. I figure if chickens need more room, so do people. I'm for the building program. Amen. If you have no more stupid questions for me, I have to get on my way.
Here comes a young couple with a baby. Can I ask you some questions? How do you feel about the new building?
Have you seen our new baby? Isn't he adorable? He's born 15 days ago, since Jeff. He weighs 6.5 pounds.
What?
Yes.
We're very
excited about it. 6.5 pounds.
I'm asking about the new building program. 6.5 pounds.
Yes.
Coochie, coochie, coo! You're a young couple just getting started. With little Jeffrey here, there's going to be a lot of new expenses. You won't be able to give anything over and above for the new building, will you?
Yes, we will. We are searching and praying and trying to figure out all kinds of significant ways to give back.
Good, very good. Thank y'all. You don't feel like you're being obligated or anything, huh?
Oh, not at all. We figure where we're giving to the building, how we're doing that is we're looking at little Jeff here, and he's going to be learning the new song, This Little Light of Mine, which we all love and adore. And then he's going to be growing up with the YOU and having fun with them. And he's going to be learning about Christ consciousness. That's very important to us. And we figure that when we invest in Jeff, we're going to be investing in his future.
Oh, yes. And when we give to God, it'll be a gift not only to God, but to our son and his future, too.
Very good. Take care of that lazy eye.
You know what? Yeah. You know what they say about, you know what Mother Teresa says about judging people now? She says, if you judge people, you can't love them. And we just love Jeff so much, right?
He's perfect.
So far, we're finding lots of serious commitment to this new building program. Surely we can find some interviews with a little more action in them. Oh, boy, here comes Negative Ned. He's against everything. What do you think of the plans for the new building program?
I'm against it.
Well, boy, am I surprised.
Well, why are you against it, Ned? What were you opposed to?
Where do I want me to start? It's too big. It's too much. Too soon. We don't need a new building. Why, just a couple weeks ago, I saw an empty seat back in the back row there. And besides, if you get another building, you need a bigger parking lot. Why can't people just walk to church? Be good for them not to be so lazy for a change. Besides, they already have that incredibly handsome, extremely intelligent minister down there, Jim Rosebud or Rose Garland.
Rose Murky.
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, here comes Positive Pauline. This should really be interesting. Pauline, I was just talking to Nanny about the new church building program. What are your views?
Oh, I'm so excited. I can't even stand it. The new building, more ministries, more people, bigger choir, new fellowship hall. Oh, my goodness, I couldn't be happier.
Well, you two have a lot to talk about. It's Matt Root with a gold tattoo. A.K.A. Lady Miracle of Miracles Tattoo Parlor.
Joy, down in my heart.
Lady Miracle, what are your plans for the Capitol campaign?
I've already did it. Valentine tattoos. Heart, red hearts. Pink hearts. Green hearts. Yellow hearts. Purple hearts. Chartreuse hearts. Polka dot hearts. Stripe hearts. Plaid hearts.
You're all heart.
Yes. It makes me feel so good when I make my commitment. I give from my heart. And everybody tells me my aura just glows and glows and glows. And even my golden tattoo heart seemed to triple 3 times its size.
Just kidding.
One thing I know for sure, my heart is full of peace and joy. And I'm now drinking from my saucer, for my cup is overflowing. Mm-hmm. I have the joy, joy, joy down in my heart.
Here comes a couple of young ladies to share their points of view.
I can't wait to bring my new friends to the new fellowship hall. I've been saving my city money every month, and Mom saved hers in a coffee can. She saved $500. She felt blessed.
Story.
Hi, y'all.
Well, I'm real happy to be able to invest in our new church home. I don't think I'll be around much longer to enjoy it, though. I'm 95 years old, you know. And have a short memory.
Big heart.
I'm real grateful that I can give for those who'll be following after me.
It's my legacy of love. I've decided I'm going to give every Sunday, and I've put the church in my will. And I can give more, knowing that I won't be needing it around here much longer. I don't think I'll need it where I'm going. Did I tell you I'm 95 years old? I don't even buy green tomatoes anymore. Don't you mean bananas?
Those two. Toodaloo. Oh, man.
Just got off the banana boat. You were driving it.
Oh, Nick, please, come on.
Oh, here's an attractive businessman.
Woo! Vivian.
When it comes to radical generosity, do you take it with a grain of salt or a loving spoonful?
And can you give us your thoughts on transformative generosity?
No, it's like this. It's God's grace. That's what it is. I'm an investor. I was trained in investing in deals that would bring huge. you Yanks have been watching Italian returns. And one of the best is God's kingdom. There's no greater return. I've never lost. And I've been blessed with pure prosperity. Yes. Put your hand down. I'm not done yet. So that you can't lose in investing. And this is one deal that I want to get in on because I can't lose.
I'll give you my piggy bank.
Oh, thank you.
Don't you get it?
Oh, there was some radical giving.
Well, there's been plenty of food for thought today. I've talked to many, and most are carefully and prayerfully considering their personal participation in the Unity Grand Adventure.
Woohoo!
Well, there's still some in the discussion stage.
Oh, Ned, we are supposed to be growing and expanding our awareness.
Awareness? That's another thing I'm against.
Well, that's it from your roving reporter, Snoopy Sue, sounding off. I mean, signing off!